Hey guys, it is Saturday and we are on the road to Northern Alabama for the Hit Songwriter series at Ferguson Farms. I'm going to be performing tonight with my buddies Brady Seals from Little Texas and Grammy-winning, multi-platinum selling songwriter Gordon Kennedy, who wrote to Eric Clapton's Change the World. We're going to go down for a songwriter show tonight. It's going to be a lot of fun. Thought I'd take you along with me. Plus, we're going to have a normal little vlog on the road as well. We're going to talk about a big issue that was circling around Nashville this week called Pay for Play. We got all that coming up on the other side of the intro after this. Gather up you weary souls, show them you ain't dead. Tell them all you ain't coming home. Woo, rise. Woo, rise. Woo. So we are out on the road and almost made it out of Nashville, and then I had a thought. I'm not sure if the venue is gonna have guitar stands or not, so we are going to make a quick stop off at Guitar Center and pick up a few guitar stands for me and Brady and Gordon, just in case the venue doesn't have them, then we'll get back on the road. So here we go. Guys, we are back. We're on the road. Got the three guitar stands. Stopped by Guitar Center. Big shout out to my buddy Greg and everybody over at Guitar Center Pro. They always seem to hook me up and treat me really right. So not a paid thing or anything, but if you want your audio gear, you want it at a good price, nice, friendly people, Guitar Center's the place for you. But we got the three guitar stands and we are back on the road. Welcome to this week's vlog. Like I said in the beginning, today, you're watching this on Tuesday, but I'm filming all this on Saturday, May 19th, as I head down to perform for the Ferguson Farms Hit Songwriter Series in Union Grove, Alabama, which is about 30 minutes outside Huntsville. Me and Brady Seals from Little Texas and Gordon Kennedy are gonna go down and play some hit songs we've written for other artists and TV shows and movies and all kinds of cool stuff, and tell the stories behind them as well. It's a lot of fun. We get a chance to do these all over the country when summer and fall rolls around, and I enjoy the hell out of it. It's a great time. But that's what we're doing today. You're going to get to see some of the performances I'm going to film all day long, and then, of course, edit everything together for this week's vlog, which you're watching right now on Tuesday. So, welcome and happy Tuesday, even though it's not really Tuesday, it's Saturday for me. But anyway, if I focus on that, I'm going to get really lost and confused, and I need to pay attention on vlogging while I'm driving. Anyway, as always, guys, before we get started, if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. I absolutely love it when you do that. Just go down there and click on the subscription button, but also make sure you click the bell notification thing next to it, the little bell icon. Under the new terms of service and everything with YouTube, if you don't click that bell, then it will not notify you when I upload a new video. Now, simply subscribing doesn't do it anymore. You've got to hit that little bell icon to make sure that you're notified every time I upload new content. That's it. Thank you. Today's vlog, we're going to talk about something that was kind of a hot topic around Nashville this week, because we've got CMA Fest coming up, and you know, a lot of independent artists and artists that aren't signed to major labels and things like that, they often get overlooked when it comes to playing at the CMA Fest on either the river stages or, of course, the stage at Nissan Stadium. So what they want to do is they want to take advantage of trying to grow their fan base, because hundreds of thousands of people come into town, come to Nashville for CMA Fest, and they want to get their name out there. So what they try to do is book gigs in local bars and venues and things like that, so that while people are in town for CMA Fest, they can, you know, see them perform at some of the smaller venues around town that aren't actually associated with CMA Fest. But the hundreds of thousands of people that come to town for that week have to have something to do, and there's not main stage shows until the night. So, but one of the things that came out this week was a thing called pay for play. And there was one particular venue that an artist got on Facebook and mentioned that they had inquired about playing there during CMA Fest, and the venue owner told them that they certainly could, but they were going to have to pay to play during CMA Fest. Now, I have a little bit different take on this than just about everybody else. I've been in this business for over 20 years. I can tell you with all confidence and certainty that the music business, as a general rule, is pay for play. It really shocked me the amount of surprise and outrage by a lot of artists that weren't aware that this is how it goes. It just is. We have another big event in Nashville called CRS. It's the Country Radio Seminar, and it's about 3 or 4 days, and it's always like the last week of February, first week of March. And what it is most of the medium market, large market program directors from radio stations all over the country, even small market, they come to Nashville for the Country Radio Seminar. And it's a big schmooze fest during the week where a lot of the major artists stay in town, and they do private parties and private shows for a lot of the radio stations as a incentive for them to play their music for the upcoming year. And it's, like I said, it's a big schmooze fest, and that's just what it is. Well, kind of the same thing during CMA Fest. A lot of unknown artists or independent artists that don't have the clout or the success to be involved in the normal activities, they will usually play the local bars in the afternoon and nights. Well, that's been pay for play for years as well. So when I start to see people coming out of the woodwork being so shocked that this goes on, I wonder where a lot of these people have been in the business. Are you just starting out? Do you not know the rules of the game? I mean, this business is pay for play everywhere. You want on the radio, you pay for play. You want on the top Spotify playlist, you pay to play. You want to play on a stage during CMA Fest or during CRS or another big event, you're going to pay to play. I guess I don't understand why these artists thought that this would be any different than any other area of the music business. And like I said, it's been going on for years. I can remember and go back to, it was 12 or 13 years ago, I was running a record label, and we had an artist that we wanted to do some stuff with during the Country Radio Seminar, and we had to pay $3,600 for this artist to play one of the stages at Tootsie's downtown during the Country Radio Seminar. It was pay for play. Now, a lot of the venues don't come right out and do what this guy did and just said, yeah, I'm going to charge you X amount of dollars to play on stage. They call them showcases. And that's how a lot of them get around the pay for play, because let's face it, pay for play is an ugly word, and nobody wants to come right out and say it. Doesn't mean they want your money any less. It just means it's a bad and derogatory term. So they came up with this term, showcase. And basically what that means is they block hours or half hours or full nights at these clubs off to sell to independent artists and offer them as showcases. And for $1,500 or $2,000 or $5,000, whatever it might be, if you can pay the price, then you can play on that stage. Now, some will argue that that's not right, that it's immoral. Some will argue that it's a private establishment, and if you want to play on that stage, it costs so much money. If you've got the money, then you can do that, and all is well. My argument is, I guess, a little bit of both, really. It's like I said, if you've been in this business for 5 minutes, you learn really quickly that everything in this business is pay to play. Like I said, again, you want to get your song on the radio, you got to pay for it. You want your song on Spotify playlists, you got to pay for it. You want social media promotion, you've got to pay for it. You want end cap status at Best Buy and Target, you've got to pay for it. Everything in this business is pay to play. So, but the other side of the coin, I do see where Nashville puts off this facade of being a creative community for by the artists, and that we support each other and we love each other and we just all get along like one big happy family. Well, that's not true. We want you to think that's true, but that's not how it really is. Every door you want to get into in the music business, there's going to be a guy standing out front holding his hand out. It's just the way that it is. People don't produce music for free. I don't produce records for free. Now, people aren't even writing songs for free, like co-writing. You want to come to town and write with the hit songwriter? You're going to pay for it. So, should it be that way? No, I don't think it should. If we want to actually have the reputation that we try to throw out into the world, that we're this close-knit, tight-knit, family-oriented, musical, creative community in Nashville, then I at least think that our actions should speak louder than our words. But oftentimes, you as an independent artist or new artist, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And you know that everywhere you turn, somebody's got their hand out. Now back to the other side of the coin. It's like I said, people have to make a living. These bars have to make a living, or they shut down, or they have to sell, or they go out of business. Same thing with producers, same thing with video producers, same thing with everybody. We've got to somehow create a sense of communication between people that you are going to have to pay for what you want in this business. Just like you can't walk into Target or Walmart or Best Buy or any other retail store and just go in and take what you want and walk out the front door because you're talented. Doesn't mean anything. As independent artists, you need to be prepared. You're gonna have to pay to play everywhere you go. At least until you get to the point where people are paying for you to play. It's just how it works. And the sooner you realize that, and the sooner you understand that this is a game, and there are rules, and if you want to succeed at the game, you've got to play by the rules that are already set. Now, God bless all of you independent artists out there that are going up against the grain. I work with a lot of you. I love working with you. That's why I do every year my independent artist production packages, where I pick several independent artists and I cut my rate to produce their records and EPs significantly, because I believe in those artists and I want to see them have quality product. I think everybody could stand to do a little bit more of that and help out the little guy. And those of us that have been lucky enough to have success in this business, to be able to reach back down and help those that are coming up behind us, I just think it's our duty. And we all know that most independent artists don't come with huge investors attached to them, and most of them don't come to town and have just gobs and gobs of money to throw around and to spend. So I would encourage those of us that have been successful in this business to yes, we have to make a living, we have to provide for our families, but somewhere between there and making a living is helping people and being passionate about projects. And yes, putting food on the table, but also making it affordable, where people that don't have a big bankroll, but have all the talent in the world, have the access to the tools and the sound and the quality that the major label artists have so that they can be competitive. So pay for play, good thing, bad thing. I think it's a good thing. I think it's a bad thing. I think it comes down to, like I said before, knowing the game and knowing the rules. If you want to try to change the rules, more power to you, and I'll show up to that fight with you. I do it every single day. But right now, the rules are what they are. If you don't want to play that venue and you can't pay that price or don't want to, then don't. The reason these bars and these venues are able to do what they do is because artists keep paying the price. If you want to change the rules, then stop playing by those rules. If you want to see these venues stop the pay-for-play system, then stop paying to play. And they'll get the picture pretty quick.
Was the Mute Brutes of Labor. And if we had been the group to put the song out, we probably would have given the copyright for Change the World the equivalent of a nice funeral. But because Clapton did it instead of us, it was a number one on Billboard for 13 straight weeks, and it stayed in the top 20 AC charts on Billboard for a record 81 straight weeks. So thanks to Steve for letting me be here tonight. Yeah. So thank you. If I could reach the stars, yeah. Pull one down for you and shine it on my heart so you can see the truth. That this love I have inside is everything it seems, but for now I find it's only in my dreams. I can change the world. I would be the sunlight in your universe. You would think my love's really something good, baby. If I could, I'd change the world.
Steve so kindly was talking about my past. Back in the 90s, I was with a band called Little Texas. And I had the opportunity to sing this next song as the lead singer. You know, we had a lead singer, his name was Tim Rushlow, and I wrote this song, and it was the last song that we recorded, and it almost didn't make the record at all. And Tim had went out to like sing the thing, and it just never really like happened for him. He just didn't feel it or whatever. So they were like, "Seals, you go out and try it," like on a whim, you know. So I went out there to try it, and sure enough, because I wrote it, I was able to feel it, and we released it, and it became a number one song. So. get on your mark, get set, ready or not, here I come. You've been looking for love, honey, I can give you some. When your world is standing still, I can turn it around, put your head up in the clouds and pick your feet off the ground. My love, are you ready for my love, my love? My love is ready for you. If you're looking for a heart that's always true, only to you, then my love is ready for you.
It's so funny how we write these songs sometimes and we think we know the destination. And we really don't, and it comes back around. But this song meant a lot to me, and it's called I'll Fight For You. You were running from the cops on a high-speed chase. Pack your suitcase and head for Mexico. No need for explanations. I'll meet you at the border. They back us in a corner. There ain't no doubt I'm going down to you, 'cause I'll fight for you. Cross the line for you. Stand on your side. Your alibi to tell the truth. Everybody's there when it's easy. They all say yes when it's convenient. But when the going gets tough, sign me up to fight.
Hey guys, thank you so much for checking out this week's vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you got something out of it. If you did, be sure and click that thumbs up button one time. Let me know that you like it. If you didn't like it at all, hit the thumbs down button. Just make sure that you hit it twice. Again, guys, thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed some of the songs, some of the footage, and me taking you along with me on the journey down to Huntsville. It's late right now. It's like after almost 1 o'clock in the morning, so, but it was worth it. It was a great trip, great getting to perform and do some songs with my buddies Brady Seals and Gordon Kennedy. As always, guys, if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. Just hit the little subscription button and the bell next to it so that you're notified every time I upload new content. Want to follow me across social media? You can do that as well. It's at the Steve Freeman across Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Twitch, just about everywhere else. I think I'm going to try and go get some sleep. I hope you guys have a great rest of the week. And as always, keep being creative. Keep pressing the boundaries. And there's nothing wrong with being independent. See you next time.